Well, there's two things that the Exo laptop that we created at One Laptop Per Child do. One is the extreme low power means that you don't need much of a power infrastructure. A little is good, but the laptops, a solar panel can power them, or a small hand crank and so forth. The other thing is network, is wireless. The laptops themselves are access points. They route the internet. It's called a mesh network. And so if a kid lives sort of 10 kilometers from the school where the access point is, his or her Google search can hop through the other kids' laptops that live, you know, closer to the school, up, you know, to the access point at the school, up to the internet, get the information, and hop, 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 back. So that extends the reach of the internet. One, a group of villages can share one access point. It's a trickle. It's not, you know, Fios speed or something, but it's much better than nothing. And even in early deployment in Peru, the actual internet access is USB thumb drive, where, you know, once a day or once a week, the teacher takes the internet requests, goes to the internet cafe, gets the answers, and brings them back to school. I mean, because they haven't sort of... We're in Peru, I just, because I've been there, I know a lot about it. The Peruvian Andes, it's pretty hard to string the cables up and down. And so this seems like a good, you know, immediate solution, and might be the reality for some time in places. In we're working in Africa, Southeast Asia, and it might be the reality depending upon the geography. In Mongolia, certainly, it's one of the most sparsely populated places on Earth. We're, you know, looking at schemes like that. U.S. government, all of the governments. I mean, it's been interesting. I think nearly every head of state on earth has contacted One Laptop Per Child about getting the laptops en masse into their countries. Exceptions, notable exceptions, North Korea and Myanmar, but that's unfortunately to be expected. But almost everyone else has expressed pretty strong interest in doing something about their education program in their country. And if you look at textbook expenditures, the average textbook expenditure in the developing world, average, some, many are below average, but average is $20 per child per year. And so if the laptop lasts 5 years, ours does, that actually pays for itself. You can give the child a laptop instead of textbooks, and you don't have to it's a one-time distribution cost. You can update the textbooks electronically. So it's very attractive in the developing world. In the developed world, I mean, Massachusetts, the state that I live in, has an annual textbook expenditure per child of $600 and something, just to be accurate, where their money isn't the problem. We have different problems in the U.S., but the mayor of Birmingham, Alabama, came to OLPC, very charismatic guy, and he just decided every kid in Birmingham, Alabama was going to get a laptop. And he came into the offices, and he raised his hands up, and he said, "Do what you have to, arrest me, I'm leaving here with two laptops." And so, you know, everybody came out of their offices and said, "Who is this guy?" But, you know, we gave him the two laptops, and he could leave with them, and he got it through whatever he had to get it through on his, you know, in process administration. And it looks like Birmingham, Alabama will do the XO laptops first. There are other New York City public school system certainly has expressed some strong interest, as have many others. And this is all several months out. I left OLPC in January, so this is just what I remember, and I'm sure these conversations have evolved and changed and so forth.